I'm giving the word here to the Zambian and the world in particular that I will develop Zambia within my period. The poor people come out of poverty within my period. I want to achieve that word, and I don't want to be disturbed by anyone who come with his manifesto.
But realistically speaking, President Muliokela, number one, you don't have any members of parliament in the house.
For example,
you don't have any councillors, you don't have any council chairperson, you don't have any mayors. And many political analysts have suggested that this particular election on the 12th of August is between the Greens and the Reds. Where is the poor people's party, getting to fall in place? Because many suggest that, you know, these elections will be about the PF and the UPND.
I'm sorry to state to you that even the last particular time, I was on the platform, though I did not have direct candidate on my party ticket because of the fees. As I have said that President Lungu and his patriotic front made the poor people miserable. If there's any president who I went to State House, President Lungu has made the poor people, we poor people, to live a more miserable life. To make our life too difficult. One, before he went to State House, the amount for nomination fee presidential were 20,000. He reduced it to 10,000. He went to State House. But after he was on State House, the following election, they rose the fee from that 10,000 to 75,000 for presidential race. And also rose the nomination fee for members of parliament, including councillors, to almost 1,000 whatever. And they made it too difficult again. The campaign program needs money again. The poor people are questionable. They cannot come in. That's how he totally stopped us. Now, today, as I'm speaking, the nomination fee has gone to 95,000 presidential. While the councillors, they are now Kumawa 5, the MPs 10,000 minimum, some 15,000, according to the paper I have, which I got from the Electoral Commission. Can you see? Where can a poor man find that money? It was one way of stopping the poor people. That's why I'm still fighting that matter. If President Lungu and his government will not retrieve, I took the matter to human people's rights. They have never responded. They have never challenged. I'm really prepared. I sought by the director of legal aid. I have one in the High Court. Can prepare the judgment default. He failed. He cannot fight the
but
so I'm
in 2016 you failed to contest the elections because of resources, I don't think you'd be on the ballot now when the nomination fee has been heightened up now. How are you going to find yourself on the ballot? Are you going to raise the 95,000 kwacha?
I have been fundraising. I've already, I currently have 8,000. I'll manage within the next year, I'll manage the remaining one. However, I will not pay that money until proper judgment has come from International Court of Justice. Why I should pay that money? Because I don't want to be taken for granted. I don't want. Enough is enough. The poor people are also part of this country, Zambia. As you see here, I'm from the Namatanda Royal Village. I'm not from a floating element. I can describe a king because the son of a king is also a king. But in my kingdom, I'm made to be a beggar. This is a very big insult on my side. And I will fight this. President Lungu and his government, it is up to them to make a decision. Because they have promised the whole world. They were visited, President Lungu was visited, and he promised that he will make sure that the election of this country will now be free and fair. Election. Now the word free and fair, I don't know where President Lungu says he's a degree holder, is a diploma holder, is a certificate holder from whatever grade 12 they're talking about. But the simple word, the dictionary, even grade 7 dictionary, it can explain the meaning of the word free. Even the word free and fair, the meaning of the word land free. What does free mean? When you pay something, nomination fee of that nature, is that election free? I want him to make proper judgment. Let them go to a dictionary. And I want proper interpretation from the judges. If not Zambian, but international judges. This, because article number 21 of the General Assembly were not written by me. It was written by the people, the nations.
But don't you think you'd be a bit unfair, President Muliokela, if you're going to throw all those shed on the back of President Lungu? Because the people that are mandated to look into these issues is the Electoral Commission of Zambia. There's already, you know, bodies that are mandated to look into issues of elections. Why don't you petition the Electoral Commission of Zambia? Why don't you drag the Electoral Commission of Zambia to court as opposed to
President
Lungu?
I have already dragged them. I have done. That's what I'm saying.
But why are you putting President Lungu into this issue?
Including, but look, the Electoral Commission chairperson, some time back I was even here, I requested President Lungu to fire him because, to me, he wants to create a problem to this country. Some countries are fighting. The reason why they are fighting is because of this nature of dictatorship. I requested President Lungu to fire that man and to put the right person so that things can go according to Article number 21 of the General Assembly. What did he do? Up to now, the chairman of elections is still there in the office, creating these problems. Other chairman, the one who signed my train of trade and conflict management was the Electoral Commission chairman. I have all the documents there on mediation. It includes the reason why countries are fighting. It includes such things, such measures of stopping other people. If you stop other people from filing nomination, what will happen to the country? You say great job. If someone has no great job but he has got money, he can go and hire criminals to start fighting. Don't take people for granted.
Is that what you're planning to do?
No, I'm not planning to do, but I'm giving an example. The reason why other countries are fighting is because of these things of stopping other people. Article number 21 says everybody is free to participate in the government of his or her own country. Free means free. Go to a dictionary. The word free does not include nomination fee. Once you put your fee, it is no longer free. It is a payment. So the election is no longer free. Fair, where a president is flying with choppers, while the other candidate who are filing nomination is walking or no footing. Is that fairness? The election is supposed to be fair, meaning if it is, they are flying, they're supposed to fly. All candidates. If they are walking, they should walk. All candidates. That is what we call fairness. But they all know, they went to school. The words are clear. You can go to a dictionary to find out the meanings. Now, is that what they do? They're not doing that. They even say someone should go up to grade 12. Converting my document to grade 12. I have higher papers. That is a strategy of stopping other people.
I know your phone is ringing, but if you're joining the conversation on the Movie TV Plus, okay? Channel 1, the top star decoder, Channel 104.
Hello.
Later on, you'll be able to come through and give us your contributions, sir, on the number that is scrolling on your screen. Those that are joining the conversation from across the continent of
Africa,
can use our social media platforms. Our handle is Ask Movie TV. I do know for a fact that you are answering your call. And,
I just ask you other question. Me, I'm on the platform.
Yeah, of course. Probably maybe you can put your phone on silent so that you know, we don't get disturbed as the program is going on. Now,
so that's what I'm saying, that I need the government to go and sit down. The conflict, according to what they trained me, train of trade and in national conflict management, including the reason why other countries are fighting. Maybe Zambia we have peace. But if this dictatorship kind of government continue, there will be no peace. Because the so-called people who are being eliminated can also do something. But if you allow them to file nomination without giving them what? And according to Article number 21, the Electoral Commission have got that power to call stakeholder meeting and to make a decision, whatever decision. That's what we call to legislate. They can legislate, like Parliament can legislate, they can make law. They are the right to make those laws. But let me assure you, Public Order Act dictates that law can only be law if it has been taken to referendum. There's no time when the electoral code of conduct, whatever they're deciding there, was taken to a referendum. That's where I'm winning. That's why they're failing me to respond. I'm winning the matter in the International Court of Justice. Because they have never held a referendum. According to the law, the Electoral Commission, even those stakeholders who hold those meetings, to divert fees, to give those fees, they've got a case to answer, including President Lungu himself. Because he is the one who's about to control. Even the Electoral Commission chairman, whom he appointed, is failing to comply to the law. He was supposed to fire him and they hire somebody who can comply to that law. Because he has got power to hire and to fire as a president of the Republic of Zambia, given to him under the Constitution of Zambia. But when he tolerates such people who want to create a war to this country, then he's part of that war. He's accepting. He's a part of that. So that's what I'm looking at him. But I have fundraising money. I will never pay that money to ECZ until I have the judgment. They have proven to me the meaning of the word free. They have proven to me the meaning of the word fair. That I will do within this period. I'm promising the Zambia.
I'll allow you to pick your call. Yes, we can pick the call and tell them that you're on the program so that we run the program.
Hello. Please, I'm in the program. Can you forgive me, please?